Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install the latest version of Jupyter Notebook on a Windows operating system. And after that, I am also going to show you how to use Jupyter Notebook for writing Python programs. So in this video, we are not going to install Anaconda, so it will be Jupyter Notebook only, so it will be very lightweight and you can start with your machine learning journey right on Jupyter Notebook. So everything I am going to show you on this video. So do watch the video till the end. If you face any issues, you can always ask me on comment sections. And I'm also on Instagram now, so you can also follow me over there and you can ask all of your doubts over there as well. I'm definitely going to help you. So now to install Jupyter Notebook, it is very important to have Python installed on your system. So for that, you need to first simply go to favorite browser to just search over here, Python download. So just download your Python and install that. So this is the latest version of our Python and we are going to download it for Windows. So I'm going to click on this download button and immediately you see Python is directly downloaded over here. So you need to just simply click on this installer to install it locally on our system. So install Python 3.13.2. Let's minimize our download directory. You need to select both these two options and then you need to click on custom installation. So here under optional features, everything need to be directly checked and click on next. And under advanced options, you need to select this first one, that is install Python 3.13 for all users. I need to keep everything as default and click on install. That will immediately ask for administrative privileges. Click on yes and our Python installation is rightly begun. So let's wait for a couple of minutes over here. So we'll come back. And now you can clearly see that our Python setup is successful. So you can just simply click on close. And now just simply go to search and just simply type cmd to open your command prompt. And within command prompt, if you just simply type python space dash dash version and just simply hit enter, you are getting this type of prompt. That is Python 3.13.2. So if you are getting this type of prompt, then all that basically means is your Python is rightly installed. Next, you need to also have pip. So pip is also gets installed along with Python. So let's verify pip version also. So just simply type pip dash version. Sorry, it will be dash dash version. And just simply hit enter. And you are getting the pip version as well coming over here. So now you can see everything is fine. It's time to install our Jupyter Notebook. So to install Jupyter Notebook, just simply type pip install Jupyter and just simply hit enter. So that's going to immediately start fetching all the files from internet and going to install our Jupyter Notebook locally on our system. You can see it's collecting and downloading, so you need to have active internet connection as well. So it's actually started downloading. Let's wait for a minute, and by the time it gets installed, I'll also request you to subscribe your channel Geeky Script along with Geeky Syntax. So here also regularly I am posting lot of coding related videos, so don't forget to subscribe your channel Geeky Syntax. Along with, you can also watch our WordPress videos. So some videos are 1 hour, some videos are 1 hour 30 minute video. So you can watch all these videos on our channel for completely free. So basically you can watch this entire playlist. Alright, so all these links I am going to provide on our channel description. And you can see that it is also rightly done. So our Jupyter Notebook is rightly installed. Right. So now it's time to launch our Jupyter Notebook. To launch, just simply type python space dash m notebook. That's it. Just simply hit enter. So that's going to start a server and going to redirect it to your browser on localhost 8888, you will get our Jupyter Notebook up and running. So if you go back to your command prompt, you can see that a local server is up and running and it is, you know, shown on our browser. Right. So you need to keep this command prompt running. You should not close this. So if you close this, then immediately your server will get disconnected and you are going to lost this connection. Right, so you need to keep it running and you can work on your Jupyter Notebook. So let's create a new Python file on a new untitled IPYNB file on a Jupyter Notebook, and you can write your Python code snippets over here. So you can print something like hello world. Just simply click on this run button, you are getting the output coming over here. You can add a couple of number, so let's say equal to 5, b equal to 2, and you want to print summation of these two number, a plus b. So we'll get a plus b. So when you click on run button, you are getting the output coming on our console, right? So not console, just output shell, right? So yeah, you can always click on this add a new shell and you'll get a new shell over here. You can duplicate also. Let's say you want to duplicate it, just simply click on that. Now you got a duplicate of the same element. If you want to insert one cell above to this, you can always click on this icon. So now you have a cell above to that item. You can click on this, so that will have a shell just below to that. So yeah, you can also delete it. So all these different things you can do. You can give some file name and save this file also. So let's give the file name as hello world. Just rename this and a file is actually saved, so it will be saved right up over here. So every time when you restart your Jupyter Notebook by just simply using this command called python-m notebook and you start your server, you will get it up and running localhost 8888 on your browser, and you'll get that saved file that was saved previously, and you can just open it from here also. You can see it is open, right? So yeah, so that's how you install latest version of Jupyter Notebook and you can start working on your machine learning projects on Jupyter Notebook. You can also work on your Python assignments on Jupyter Notebook as well. So that's basically all about this video. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel Geeky Syntax. So here also regularly I am posting a lot of coding related videos. So don't forget to subscribe to our main channel Geeky Script along with Geeky Syntax. And also if you're interested on WordPress, you can watch all these different videos on our channel for completely free. So you can basically watch this entire playlist. So all these videos link I'm going to provide right in our channel description. So from there you can watch all these different videos on our channel for completely free. And lastly, special thanks to the supporters of our channel. We are truly grateful to you guys. Supports like this really motivate us to create and improving these videos. Again, thanks a lot for being an essential part of our journey. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video and God bless you all.